Let's go over the answers to the assessment you just took. So this was the question you were presented with. The derivative, the 52nd order derivative of sine x, and then you were given two choices, either equals sine x or negative sine x. Okay, so how do you go about doing this problem? Of course, you don't want to actually take the derivative of sine 52 times. So if you recall what we saw on the slide just before the quiz, actually, was this slide. And in the gray box there, you'll see that it says, we see that the higher order derivatives of the sine function are cyclic. And then even ordered higher derivatives of sine give positive or negative sine x. So you'll see like the second derivative of sine gives negative sine x. The fourth derivative of sine gives positive sine x. And then it's cyclic after that. So it keeps repeating that same pattern. And then we'll see that it says this pattern can be summarized by the following formula. And we have this formula. Okay, so this is the formula we're actually going to use to answer this question. So let's go back to the board here. And let me just copy down that formula over here. And then we'll go over what it means. Okay. So the left side of this formula maybe looks a little funny. This is the derivative notation, but we have this 2n. All this is saying is the 2n order derivative of sine. Okay, so for example, if I had this, the fourth derivative, and I was looking at this formula, then my n would be 2. But anyway, the 2n is just referring to the order of the derivative of sine x, and then it gives me this formula. It's negative 1 to the n, where that n is referring to the same n from the left-hand side, times sine x. Okay, so how do I actually apply this formula? So let's use it on our problem. So we have the 52 order derivative basically, all you have to do is figure out what n should be, right? So this is an even ordered derivative of sine. So I know that my answer is going to be either positive sine or negative sine. And I can use this formula to help me figure out which one, okay? So I need to figure out, basically, 2n equals 52. I want to know what n needs to be, okay? So then n would be 52 divided by 2. Which is 26. Okay, so in our case then, n equals 26. So I could write this, if I wanted to, as d to the 2 times 26, right? The 2 times 26 order derivative of sine of x. And then once we know that, we just follow through on the right-hand side. Okay, we know that n is 26, we just figured that out, times sine x. Okay, and then what's negative 1 to the 26th? Well, negative 1 to any even power is going to be positive 1, right? Like negative 1 squared, negative 1 to the 4th, those are all positive 1. So this is going to be 1 times sine x, and we see that our answer is positive sine. Okay. And so that should have been the answer. Hopefully now it makes a little more sense. So basically you're using this formula. All you have to do is figure out what n is in your case, and then it's pretty straightforward from there.